Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing The River of Doubt, Theodore Roosevelt's Darkest Journey book by Candace Millard. President Theodore Teddy Roosevelt chooses to embark an adventure to a place so dangerous and remote that it's hard to fathom why anyone would choose travel there, much less a former United States president. But that was the kind of man Teddy was. The River of Doubt is as entertaining as a historical novel can be engaging, detailed, brutally honest, and direct. A bit difficult for the non-history buff to read, but worth every shred of effort to do so. Facing a life of lecturing and writing after losing to Wilson and splitting the GOP vote with Taft in 1912, T.R. seizes on an opportunity to visit South America on a lecture tour. The River of Doubt is so named because no one has ever followed it from its source to its terminus, and it is unknown. The journey is poorly organized and provisioned. This seems to be universal to explorers up until recent times. She explored the political conditions of the time, the family dynamics of Roosevelt, the backgrounds of the key characters, and the motivations of the principals. She wrote of the flora and fauna and explained how they played a key part in the difficulties of the trip. The interaction, or lack of interaction, of the expedition with the natives was a continuing theme, and held the reader wondering if and when they would appear from the jungle. Seemed like the last half of the expedition was condensed into just a few short chapters at the end. Maybe all the key action was in the first part of the journey, but it seemed a little hurried at the finish. Ultimately, Roosevelt and Rondon put on the map a 1,000-mile-long river, which was to be renamed from River of Doubt, hence the title, to River Roosevelt, as it stands today. In 1912, after being defeated as a third-party candidate for president, Theodore Roosevelt was deeply depressed and out of a job. This is a great book that includes history, biography, natural science, and incredible human drama. She peppers her telling with quotes taken straight from her subjects, which pulls you in and makes you feel like the account is as authentic as it can be. Roosevelt is portrayed as a great but flawed man driven by ambition and adventure on a journey of nearly fatal danger. Read it while in Brazil hiking in the forests, which made it even more real. This book is quite a page-turner. Funny thing how a title or a subject catches your eye. In addition, there is Kermit Roosevelt, Theodore's son who came along to protect his father and ended up needing to be watched himself. She goes from discussing the ground cover to the trees overhead and how they grow, to the rapids, man-eating fish, and even a murder. One really gets to appreciate and admire what explorers of unknown territories really went through. If you want to understand what an incredible human being T.R. was, you need to read this book. Here is a link to actually hear the actual voice of the actual Theodore Roosevelt during the long ago campaign of 1912. The remarkable true story of Roosevelt's exploration of the Rio de Duvida, later renamed Roosevelt River, with legendary Brazilian explorer Candido Rondon. How any man could be brought in close personal contact with Colonel Roosevelt without loving the man. His biography reads almost like a prescription for getting everything one can out of life, to seize every adventure, to pursue every ideal, and to hold fast to one's personal moral code. He is surrounded by a number of other exceptional individuals: the great Brazilian explorer Colonel Rondon, Roosevelt's own tormented but brave son Kermit, and a group of braileys and camaradas who range from the most tireless and fearless to the most venal. Unimaginable challenges awaited them: unpredictably difficult terrain, roaring rapids, ravenous jungles, arduous portages, inadequate provisions, cultural barriers within the exploring party, disease-carrying insects, and hostile, cannibalistic, and stealthy indigenous peoples. She has a great gift for relating the sensory flavor of the ecosystem through which Roosevelt and his company traveled. She brings the rainforest to life and conveys the dangers to Roosevelt's party with an immediacy and comprehension that even the participants could not have fully possessed. This was a man who refused to be shown any deference, who refused to sit if Colonel Rondon, the Brazilian commander, was not also so seated. This was also a man who, if his ailing condition became a burden to the rest of the expedition, resolved to take his own life rather than to jeopardize those of others. It is truly sobering to realize how great a risk Roosevelt took in leading this expedition. At times, the Brazilian commander Colonel Rondon's plodding determination to survey the landscape, even at the cost of a risky loss of time and provisions, vexed Roosevelt utterly. This expedition brought out the most in young Kermit, though his conduct was not without mistakes. Kermit's life ultimately ended in tragedy, but his conduct on this expedition would make any father deeply proud. This is a book that must be experienced as well as read, easily one of the top 5 books of the decade. It was flawlessly researched, and shows an absorbing side of Teddy Roosevelt, and his son, Kermit. There were perils around every bend of the river from rapids to wildlife that kept this reader interested in following this book to the end. In addition to capturing the details of the journey, the author does a terrific job of placing it within the context of the political and social environment of the times. The author also does a great job of adding color to the story by explaining things that the participants themselves had no way of knowing, such as dangers of the jungle and its inhabitants that were completely obscure to the expedition party. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe and leave your comments below.